say as a youngster, I heard, hey, stay away from this stuff. That's carnival stuff, you know. It's not something you want to get involved with. You'll end up looking like me, and you'll have to either work in a circus, picking up behind elephants, or doing this, for instance, you know. And I said, well, gee, that's kind of what I'd like to do.
Wow, this could only be Rise with Chuck. 1,000 years ago, we shot this opening of Ray Youngman tattooing his wife, Tony. Afterwards, we followed them in their 1953 Oldsmobile. Ray was in town recently, and I had a chance to talk with him in his shop.
I guess it started when I was a young man. My father was a World War II veteran. He was heavily tattooed. He had quite a bit done overseas and in the U.S. He was in the Navy, and it was always exciting, you know, to see these tattoos that he had. I mean, historical, because what they did was depict was history, and they were always, you know, like cool, aggressive, kind of magic, menacing and enchanting at the same time as a young boy. So I had an interest in art. I mean, I was always working with visuals, and so I would mimic this type of thing, the tattoo thing on paper, and that kind of thing, and draw on my friends, you know, and it got to a tattooer in my area there in Spokane, outside of Spokane, Washington. My father knew him quite well, so we had access to this this gentleman and this establishment of his as young kids. So that was quite an influence on me, quite an inspiration. It's like, wow, you know, this is some real magic this guy's producing. It was me. And of course, as a youngster, I heard, hey, stay away from this stuff. That's carnival stuff, you know. It's not something you want to get involved with. You'll end up looking like me, and you'll have to either work in a circus, picking up behind elephants, or doing this, for instance, you know. And I said, well, gee, that's kind of what I'd like to do. And so with resistance, I would say professionally, I just kind of did some back alley dabbling and took a lot of what I did know and probably a lot more of what I didn't know and just kind of worked with them until I got to a point where it just became my life, which was at an early age too. In 1968, I did my first electric tattoo, and that was in Downers Grove. And from that time on, I just progressed and developed and grew as a traditional tattooer, growing up in a traditional era of the 50s and 60s and early 70s, you know. And 1966, we came here from Washington State. My father worked with the Teamsters and Jimmy Hoffa in transportation and that kind of thing at that time. So I saw Chicago as like, wow, it was like, I don't know, you know, circuses, motorcycle clubs, greasers, sailors, just the coolest place to be. I became like a hospice to the eccentrics. The things that I was involved with was a totally different culture. People that were into tattoos were, you know, a little more on the eccentric side, say, or a little more reclusive. And So a lot of these individuals just sharing their lives with me, and you know, our spiritual, emotional, physical, and mental connection, you know, brought a whole new world, which became a world of the odd and unusual and strange, and also enchantment from all around the world. So it's been really kind of exciting, of course, in Downers Grove, we've been here on the strip on Ogden since 1985. We've moved to 5 different locations. We've been at this location here now, which is kind of like a landmark location with the Sybaris across the street and Army Navy Surplus. Chicago's was right next to us here. They just closed last year. So we've been here quite a while, and we'd like to see more of that. But the family travel back and forth, and we're in Spokane, Washington as well now. But we're still as a tattoo family, a traditional family, probably the tail end of the old school. We're excited to be here and there. And we're 100% active in this in every way still today. And again, Downers Grove has been a great place to create this legacy that the tattoo family Youngman has, and the friends that we've developed, and everything else. I mean, boy, if I could change it,
okay,
I wouldn't. You know, because it doesn't get any better than this. So it's been a great journey. It's been a lot of fun. It's taken me, into the car collecting and hot rods and lead sleds. I've done the custom Kemp shows through the country and met some of the, influential people in my life in that car thing too, and everything's just been really probably the best. I have no regrets, and I wouldn't change a thing. It's just been really a lot of fun, and good food too. I can't forget that. It's always great to be here, and this is where my heart is. So I appreciate it, and
thanks for talking to me.
Thank you, Chuck. It's always a pleasure.